Hello friends, good morning, good afternoon and good evening to one and all joining from all over the world. Welcome to Letterkenny Islands Developer Group. We are going to start a new virtual learning series on JavaScript, and today is our first day where we'll be talking about the JavaScript fundamentals. So about our community group, it's based out in Letterkenny, Ireland, and you can reach out to us at Twitter at LKSFDevs and follow us on Facebook at LK Trailblazers. We have our community group at bit.ly/lksfdevs where you can check out all our upcoming sessions and register for them. You can also check out our community chatter group, which is at bit.ly/lksfchatter. On this chatter group, we'll be posting all the presentations and Q&As and all the links for the recordings. And also we do Q&As and help you out with any challenges if you are facing. You can post your queries there on the chatter group. So we can you can reach out and check out all the session recordings at bit.ly/lksfvideos. If you're watching this on YouTube, do share and subscribe our channel to share and give more love. I'm Nishant Singh Pamar, the community group leader for Letterkenny Developers Group and also Salesforce developer and consultant with Pramerica in Letterkenny. I have 6+ years of experience working on Salesforce implementation and have 10 Salesforce certification, including an application architect one. I'm a trailhead ranger and also loves music. I play guitar for hobby and also come from Udaipur in India. So for today's smooth action, just keep your videos off and microphone on mute. If you have any questions in term, you can post your questions on the Google spreadsheet at bit.ly/js-query. This Google Sheet will be open even if you are checking on the YouTube. Post your questions and we'll try to answer them before the second session. And you can join our second session on 16th of October. Register for that and join our second session. So today's our speaker is Kamal Kant Gaur. Welcome Kamal Kant Gaur to Letterkenny's Developer Group. He's technical consultant with Horizontal Digital. He would be taking us through the journey of JavaScript and teaching us through all the nuances of JavaScript. Over to you, Kamal. Thank you.
So now moving on to the course and what is the agenda for today. So today we're gonna cover first topic, what is JavaScript. Second topic, what are the variables and constraints are available in JavaScript. Third, what are the different data types in JavaScript. Fourth topic, how we can convert one data type to another data type in JavaScript. And fifth topic is if we want to compare different values in JavaScript, the comparison. Sixth topic, what are the loops available in JavaScript. Seventh topic, ternary operator and optional chaining. These are the special one that you need to keep in mind. Eighth topic is the functions. And ninth topic is the arrow functions that are introduced in new JavaScript version. So these are the topic that we're going to cover today, and these are basically JavaScript fundamentals. First topic that we have, introduction. So basically, if we are talking about the JavaScript scripting programming language, that is basically essential for the web development, and nowadays that is very essential for the mobile application, and it also used in the Salesforce by Salesforce LWC framework that we are currently using. And if we are thinking, if any kind of interaction that web page makes with the program or logic, that will happen via the JavaScript. And one thing that I want to notice you, JavaScript is a case sensitive language. So whenever we are declaring any variable or anything in JavaScript, you need to keep in mind JavaScript is case sensitive and we need to think about it before declaring any variable or anything in JavaScript. What are the different tools we're gonna use for JavaScript development in this session? So we have Google's Chrome web browser. So in the web browser, we have the console where we can write the simple program and show the output for that program, and VS Code for the complex program and the classes in later on session. But for today's session, we are just using Google's Chrome web browser. Now moving on to the JavaScript versions, what kind of the different versions available for JavaScript script? So first version of JavaScript is introduced in 1997, that is called first edition. And if you are thinking about the ECMAScript, ECMAScript is the standard that defined by the ECMAScript itself. And these are basically for the JavaScript for different browsers. So we called that first version is ECMAScript version 1, and after that in 1998 the second version is launched, and in 1999 the third version for the JavaScript is launched, and in 2009 ECMAScript 5, basically known as ES5, is launched. So all the vanilla JavaScript is launched in 2009, that is known as ES5. And in 2015, the new version of JavaScript is launched and known as ES6. So that come with the object-oriented concept in JavaScript, that introduced the object-oriented concept in JavaScript. So these are the different versions available. Now we have ES6 or ES7 and ES8 also, but these are not stable, and currently ES6 is available for all the browsers that we have currently available, and all the functionality is working fine in ES6 in different browser. So that is the introduction of JavaScript. One thing you need to keep in mind from this slide: JavaScript is a case sensitive language, and currently we are using ES6 features, and we need to follow the ES6 standard whenever you are developing any code in case of LWC, in case of React, or in case of any other JavaScript framework. Now moving on to the second topic that we have, that called as variable and constant. So what are the different type variables available in the JavaScript? We will discuss this topic into that particular slide. So what is the variable? So whenever we need to store any data into the programming language, we need a variable. So variable basically store all the data in a particular name format. And we can also use a variable to store any kind of visitor or any user data. So that is called a variable. For example, we can take an example of what is a variable. So you have an input box, and in input box you are entering a user first name, last name, and age. So all the data is now how we can use in programming language is basically used by a variable. We need to create a variable that store first name, we need to create a variable that store last name, we need to create a variable called age for storing the user age that entered into the form. Now move on to the what are the different rule are when rule we need to keep in mind when we are creating any variable. So variable name can contain letters, digit, underscore, and dollar. All are the valid in case of variable declaration. Variable never be start with numbers. It only start with basically letter, underscore, dollar sign, these kind of, but not start with the number. Please avoid reserve word. Reserve word are the word that are reserved for in any programming language. For example, we have if, else, switch, classes. This kind of reserved words are available in different programming. In case of creating variable in JavaScript, please avoid these reserved words. Variable can be start with dollar and underscore sign. So maybe if you are preparing for the JavaScript 1 developer exam, one question can be coming from this rule for variable creation. So you have given like any variable that start from number, and you need the question is that valid or not. So whenever variable is start with number, it is invalid in case of JavaScript. And what are the different variable types available in JavaScript? That is the next topic. So before ES6, we have a single variable called where, and that is var, and that store all the data like the constant one, the mutable, immutable, all the type of data will store was stored into the variable. So variable called where, and after ES6 we divided these data into the two type of variable. One is the let, that store all the changeable or reassignable value, that all the it contain all the reassignable or changeable value, and constant will only contain the read only value. It never allow to change value once it is assigned to that particular value, variable. And one thing that we need to keep in mind, where is the global context. Having global context, but the where, sorry, let and the const having block level scoping. So we will discuss more about in later session, sorry, later slide, what is the block level and global level scoping. But we need to keep in mind that where having global level, global context and global scope, but the let and const having block level scope. Now moving on to the one example that I have for the variable and const, and we can see the difference between where and let. Let me move on to the Chrome browser, and we have console window where we can write any example code that we want, or any code that we want to run in JavaScript, and we can understand the output and the concept of that. So let's take an example. We have a variable var where called a, and we never initialize with a value, we just console that variable, and if we print this value, we console this variable, we get undefined. And let's take another example. If we are consoling any value after declaring a variable, it return undefined if we are not initializing with a value. If we are consoling,
can you, Kamal, can you zoom a bit the screen, like your browser?
I think that is not visible. Is it now visible?
It's still small, but it's fine. If you can't zoom, I think console
works. Yeah, now it's working fine.
Okay. Yeah. Good. It's good. Better.
So what we did in first example, we declare a variable without initializing a value and print that variable, and we getting a value we are getting a value called undefined, and we will discuss this undefined when we are discussing different data type available in JavaScript. And another example we have, we are consoling a variable. Console means printing a variable inside JavaScript called b, and the thing is that we declare this variable after consoling. What is the output in case of where? It also undefined. So if we are console any value after the initial after declaration or before declaration, and if it is not initialized, it will return undefined in the boss in case of where. But in case of let, it will be other thing, other behavior we have. So for example, we have variable let, sorry, variable called x, and we console the value of this x. What is the output? Output is undefined. That is the same with the first one, but in case of if we are not declaring any variable and we just console that variable before declaration, what is the output? For example, we have variable called y. After printing that variable, we just declare that variable. Then what is the output? It return the reference error because y is not defined. In case of lat, if we are printing any value that is not defined, it will return the reference error. And it is very important in case of JavaScript certification in Salesforce. That is a very important question in Salesforce one, Salesforce JavaScript Developer One concern, certification. If you have any question regarding this, you can ask in Google Sheet that we shared with you. We will discuss in next session. So these are the variable and const. We already when I define the when I like we give the overview of that variable, we discuss about the block level or this block level and global scoping. So what is a variable scoping in JavaScript? Before ES6, we don't have this scoping kind of concept in JavaScript. Now in the ES6, we have concept called global scope or variable scope. In case of where type of variable, we have global context or global scope. So, and in case of lat, we have block level scope. So let's take an example. We have a block that basically a condition block, and the condition is if true, then we are declaring a variable and declaring and initializing a variable with where x equals to 5, and we are just printing that variable outside that block. So that is the block basically, and we are just printing that variable outside that block. Then what is the output in case of where it return 5, because it having global context and global scope. So whenever we are in declare or initialize a value inside a block or outside a block, it will return the value. But in case of lat, we have block level of scoping. For example, we have a block, the condition block, we have we have condition if true, and we declare and initialize a variable called y with using lat, and we are just console and print or maybe print that y outside that block. It will return the reference error because y is not defined, and the scope of for this y is only available inside that block. So that's how the block level scoping is working in ES6, and this is the main difference between the where and let. That is the main difference between where and let. Now moving on to the data type. What are the different data types available into JavaScript? So the ES6 define 8 type of data type into the JavaScript. In among the 8, 7 are the primitive data type and one is the complex data type. So what are the 7 data type, different data type? Like we have boolean, we have null, undefined, number, bigint, string, and symbol. These are the primitive data types. And one object is the complex data type. And if we are talking about the object will cover function, array, date, mathematical, operator, string S is capital in case of this string, is the object data type. So we are facing, we maybe face one issue from this object data type. And in object data type, what is the, like in exam, they can ask what is the data type of array. So data type of array is object. And other data type we have boolean, null, undefined, number, bigint, string, and symbol. First talk about the boolean. So boolean, as you already know, in different other programming language, boolean is hold true and false value. So in this JavaScript same behavior we have second data type we have is null. So what is the null? Null basically the variable that is initialized with the null value. For example, we have a variable called y, and we declare variable y and initialize with the null, and it will return the null value. So it is initialized, but it is initialized with the null value. So it is there is no data available inside the block that we declare for that particular variable. So the absence of data is called null. And because JavaScript is case sensitive that we talk in first slide, null is not this not same as capital null, camel case null, and any other variant that are available for that null. So if we are talking about the special data type, the null is contain all small character, not any other variant available. And undefined, we already talk about the undefined. A variable that is declared but not initialized is having data type called null. And number, the important, very important topic in JavaScript, the number. Any integer, any floating floating value is known as number in JavaScript. For example, we have two value 42 and 3.141. That is number. And maybe one question is coming from this particularly number. We have different data type, different type of value available in any programming language. For example, integer, float, zero, minus zero, infinity, minus infinity, NaN, not a number, is valid number in JavaScript. So keep in mind, in integer, float, zero, minus zero, infinity, minus infinity, not a number, is a valid number in JavaScript. Yes, we will cover that NaN in next slide, why, or maybe in next session with more example why it is a valid number in JavaScript. Next, we have begint. So let's take an example. We have an integer value that is very large, or we have very large number of very large value that we need to store in integer. So, but there is some kind of certain limit to store value in integer, and we need to store this value in JavaScript. So in ES6, one new concept is launched, is called begint. And how it is declared? We just need to use the value that we have, and after that small n, we just need to use that. Next topic is a string. Any sequence of character that represent a text value, like for example, any value that are coming in double quote or single quote is known as a string in JavaScript. Next topic is symbol, that is basically introduced in ES6, and this is a data type, basically unique and immutable type of data data type. And if you want to store any particular or any unique value inside a data type, then we need to use symbol. And we already talk about the object. We have func. If any data type that come if any question or anyone ask, or any like in if we need to get any data type for the function array, det, math, and s capital string, I'm talking about the capital S, and after that the string is the, there is a difference between small string, there is a misprint, that big just after that begin we have small character, a small s, and contain string. That is the there is a difference between small string as a small string and the capital string. So if we are talking about the function, the array, date, math, capital S string is object data type. We already talked about this data type in last slide. So, but I just want to explain with the more example. We already talked like, if any double quote or single quote value is in JavaScript, that known as a string. For example, we have a variable called let greeting, and that come in any value that come into the double quote, or any value that come into the single quote is known as a string. A number, if we are talking about the number, any positive, any negative, any decimal number is any decimal value is known as a number in JavaScript. We talk about the undefined. Any variable that is declared but not initialized is known as an undefined. And null is not same as undefined. We declare an initialized variable with the null. It means like there is no data available inside that particular variable. Second data type, we already talk about the object that is known as complex data type. So in JavaScript, we need to create that object. We need to fetch the data from object and we need to delete some property from that object. So how we can do? First, we need to cover how we can create different how we can create object into the JavaScript. First method we have called object literals, second object constructor, and third one is the object dot create method. So let's take an example and take an example and get more detail how we can create Java object inside a JavaScript. So first method, is object literals. For example, we need to create a variable constant, or maybe the let. We need to create a variable let. Variable name is user, and it contains all the data related with the user. So whenever we are creating any object with object literal, we have bracket, flower bracket, basically that known as a flower bracket. And inside in object, we have all the property using key value pair. So we have username, we have second property age is 32, and that's how we can create object using object literal. And if we are printing this object variable, what is the output? We can check user. Console this level, we are getting that particular object. So that's how we can create the object using object literals. Second way to how we can create object in JavaScript, that object by using object constructor. So how we can do, we just need to use let. We already user use user, so it will give the error. We need to use another example. We are using variable called x. We are just using new keyword, new object, and just define that. And if we need to initialize any property inside this, we just need to use x dot name. Same that we are using that x dot name equals to. And if we console that particular or x dot age is equal to 30, and if we are printing that particular object, what is the output? That is the variable, that is the object that we are trying to create. First way, using object literals. Second way, using object constructor. Third way, object dot create. So if we want to create a object using object dot create, how we can create? Let variable called abc, sorry, object called abc, object dot create, and we can create object. And same we did for the last abc dot name. ABC dot age 32. We print this. What is the output? It written. Okay, so. So basically, that object.create is basically used for inheritance in JavaScript. So if you see that we are creating a variable called abc and we initialize any value inside that, and we console that abc, it will return the undefined. It will return the error, unquote error. So if that basically object.create is using for inheritance, if we need to use, if we need to create a variable abc with inheriting the property from other variable, then we can use that object.create method. So we are creating a variable called xyz and using object.create, and just using the variable that we already declared x, and if we print that variable xyz, see the value, and it will return the blank object because it removed the reference for that x. So I will give complete example for that object.create next session. Basically, object.create is using for the inheritance, that inherited value from other object. First way, how first thing, how we can create data type in JavaScript. Second, how we can create object in JavaScript. Second thing, how we can fetch value from a object in JavaScript. So if we need to fetch a value from object in JavaScript, we have two type of method. First is the dot notation. Second is the array notation. So what is the dot notation? What is the dot notation? We have a object called obj, and we have a property name, and name equals to Kamal, and we need to get the name property from this object. So how we can get object dot name? So the dot is known as a dot notation. So we can fetch the value object dot name. And the second way, we have object notation. So same example, we have object and name equals to Kamal. And we just, if we are using array notation, we need to use array bracket, and inside array bracket we need to put the property, and we can get the property from object. But there is a question, why we need to use this array notation if dot notation is available, and when we need to use array notation? So let's take an example. We have a object, we have a object called obj, and inside obj we have a property first space name, and the value is Kamal. First space name, and the value is Kamal. And if we are using dot notation, obj dot first and space name, it will give error due to the space, because that will break the rule of JavaScript. And if we want to fetch the value from this object, we need to use array notation in obj array bracket, and inside array bracket we can pass the property in double quote, and we can get the value from this object. So there may be question, why we need to use array notation, and when we need to use array notation. So the answer is that if we have any property with the spaces, then we need to use array notation. And we discuss about how we can create, how we can fetch the value. Third topic we have, how we can delete a property from object. So the we have a variable called x, and inside this variable we have two property, name and id. Name equals to Kamal and id equals to 1. And if suppose that we want to delete that particular property called name, then we can just need to use the keyword delete, that is already pre-built property for from JavaScript. We just need to use that property delete and x dot name, and by using this, the property is deleted from that particular object. And if we console that variable, the output is the id. So that's how we can fetch, we can create, fetch, and delete value from an object. The next topic is that type conversion. If we want to convert one data type into the another data type, right? I'm covering topic very fast because we have very limited time. And in today's session, we need to cover fundamental, and in next session, we're gonna cover about the arrays, ES6 features. What are the different ES6 features? What are the array methods are available? So in today's session, we are covering the fundamental of JavaScript. So the topic is that now we are discussing the topic type conversion. So if you want to convert one data type into the another data type, how we can do in JavaScript. So for that, we have two type of way available into the JavaScript. By using them, we can convert one data type into the another data type. First is the implicit data type, implicit type conversion. We can call plus operator. If you want to append any value after any number or any string character, we can use that plus operator. So for example, we have a number and we want to convert this number into the string, then we can use implicit conversion. And how we can do, for example, we have a variable called x, and x having value Kamal, and if you want to append some value before that variable, how we can do x, because we declare this using let, we can assign value inside x equals to the string that we want to append and plus the variable that we already declared. So that's how we can append or maybe convert one data type to another data type. So that is the vanilla JavaScript way by using plus operator. But in the ES6, we have a different type using escape character. So we have a variable called x, and x having a value Kamal, and we want to append welcome before that Kamal. How we can do? We just need to use escape character, single that escape character, sign and welcome. And if we need to access any variable inside that particular access, how we can do? A dollar sign bracket, and inside we need to put the variable and bracket end, and that's how we can convert or maybe append any value in any dynamic variable or maybe any variable. For example, in your component, in your LWC component, you want to show a string that will show first name, last name, and in the first name and last name, or maybe the before or after, you need to append a particular string. So how you can do? You just need to use a escape character, and inside that dollar first name or maybe welcome dollar first name hyphen dollar bracket the last name and bracket. So that's how we can do that. Second way, explicit. So any inbuilt or pre-built function that we are using from JavaScript is known as an explicit way to convert one data type to another data type. For example, if we are using two string or number, then that's known as a explicit data type. So in explicit data type, the first thing is that converting to a string. For example, if you want to convert a number or a boolean to a string, how we can do? First way, if we want to convert, we can use implicit way. But if we want to use pre-built method, then how we can do? Let's take an example. We have two variable. First variable called number equals to 5. Second variable called boolean, that hold boolean value, bool, that hold boolean value equals to 2. And we want to convert these two variable into a string. So how we can use? We can use two string method that are pre-built available into the JavaScript. So number dot two string, and what is the output? It returns string 5 encoded into the double quote. Same with the bool variable, and it will return double quote true. That is the first way. Second way, if we want to convert to any value, any string or any value or any boolean into number. How we can do? So we, if you want to convert in an integer, we need to use parse int. If we need to convert into floating number, then we need to use parse float. And if we are using parse int and parse float, and if we are passing any invalid number, it will return not a number. For example, we have parse int and we are using that awkward string, then it will return NaN. And if we parse an integer value with undefined value, then it will return NaN, not a number. And the below example are very useful for point of view of exam, like parse int, and if we pass any boolean value true, then it will return 1. If we parse int false value, then it will return 0. And if we parse blank array, then it will return 0. And if we parse int using if we use parse int for a array that hold only single value, it return that value. But if we parse a array that hold multiple value, then it will return NaN. That is very strange behavior of JavaScript, but we need to keep in mind what is the output for that particular. If we pass the true, pass the false, blank array, array with single value or array with a multiple value. If we need to convert any number, any string, anything then into a boolean, how we can do? So whenever we are converting to a boolean, we need to keep in mind any false value, 0 as a big int, empty string, null, undefined, NaN, all return the false value. All return false value. That is very useful thing. So whenever we have false, we have 0 as a big int, empty string, null, undefined, NaN. And if you want to convert in these value into the null, it will convert into the boolean, then it will return the false value. The next topic, how we can convert object to string and string to object. These two topics are very useful in case of LWC. If we are using LWC and we are getting response from any API, any third party API, and that will come as a string, and we need to convert this string into the object, or maybe we need to send a data to API, then we need to convert into this object into the string, then how we can do? So if first topic, if we want to convert any object to string, then we need to use json.stringify. That is pre-built method in JavaScript. Let's take an example. We have a object called x, and in x we have property name and age, and we want to convert this object into the string. How we can do? We just need to use json.stringify, and inside that we need to just pass the variable that we created, and if we print the value, it will return the string value of that particular object. So if you see that the double quote is added before that, in double quote is added before that object. So that's how we can convert any object to string. And if we want to convert any string to a object, first we convert any object to string. Now we want to convert any string to object. How we can do? We need to use json.parse method from JavaScript. The same example we are taken. We have a string that encoded with the double quote, and we are just passing that string inside a json.parse method. And if we print that output, print the output, we can use we can see object, the bracket, object bracket, and all the property, and we can use these property inside our component or maybe our code, like x.name, x.age, that we already discussed. That's how we can convert one data type into the another data type in JavaScript. Just for the recall purpose, we have two way to convert any data type. First one is the implicit, second one is the explicit. In implicit, we are just adding any string value after or before the string. Previously, we are just using plus operator, But in the new way, we have a strict keyword, and if we want to use any variable inside that strict keyword, we just need to use dollar and bracket. And second way is the explicit way, that the pre-built, if we are using any pre-built method, first is it how we can convert any variable into the string. We just need to use to string. And if we need to convert any number, we need to use parseInt and parseFloat. And one thing that you want to notice, if we are passing any string inside parseInt and parseFloat, we are getting NaN. And if we are passing undefined in parseInt, it will also return NaN, not a number. If we parse any true value, then it will return 1. And if we parse any false value, it will return 0. If we parse any blank array, it will return 0. If we parse an array with single value, then it return that value. But if we parse array with multiple value, it return NaN. And if we converting any number, any data type to Boolean, we need to keep in mind any false value 0, 0 as a big int, integer, null, undefined, none, NaN, it will always return false value. And the last topic that we cover, how we can convert object to string and string to object. If you want to convert object to string, then we need to use json.stringify. And if you want to convert a string to object, then we need to use json.parse. So that is the type conversion. The next topic, how we can compare the different values in JavaScript. The comparison in JavaScript, how we can do. So we have double equals to and triple equals to in JavaScript. So these are the if we are comparing or maybe checking any value, there is a slightly different between double equals to and triple equals to that you need to keep in mind. Whenever we are using double equals to, that will not check the type of that particular value or variable. But in case of triple equals to, it also check the data type. If we are comparing x with the y, and if we are using double equals to, it just compare, it not checking any data type. But if we are using triple equals to, it check the data type of x and data type of y, that we need to keep in mind. For example, we have a number and we are just using double equals to for comparison a number with the string. What it will return true, because in double equals to we are not checking any kind of data type. But in case of triple equals to, it also check the data type. So once in left side we have number and right side we have a string, so it will return false. So you can see the Boolean type example, like we have true string and we are using triple equals to and we just use true as a Boolean, then it will return false. But okay, there is maybe misprint. True equals double equals to and we are using true, then it will return true. One, if we true equal double equals to, then comparing with the one, then it will return one true. And if we are using triple equals to, it will return false. So you need to keep in mind always when you are using double equals to and triple equals to, if you want a comparison data type, then you need to use triple equals to. And if you just want to compare the value, you need to use double equals to.
So Kamal, what was the change? I think this should be true, right? When it's just double equal to.
Yeah, two double equals to equals true, then it will return true because it's not checking the data type.
Okay. Rest is correct.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay.
Next topic we have, what are the loops available into the JavaScript? So in JavaScript we have basically different type of loops we will cover into the
I tried that in the console log through that in the earlier slide, it is giving me false only.
Hello, yeah people.
Yeah, so like in the earlier slide you showed in the double is true, double equal to true, right? It is giving me false only.
Okay, I will check and let you know in next session what is the
on the
why it
code
is
logic.
behaving like
So
this,
yeah.
because
Okay, sure.
let me know. I need to keep in track so we can discuss in the next session.
I'll put as open question. No worries. Thank you.
Thank you. We have loops. So we currently we are just discussing these two loops, while loop and for loop, and all other loops that are basically working with the array. So when we are discussing collection, we are discussing other looping method like for each ma dot map method. These are working with the loop array. So we will discuss in later session. So currently we are discussing while loop, how while loop working. So if you are aware about any other language, it will behave like same that same work in other language. So what kind of syntax we have for while? We have while, and under the while we just need to pass the condition, and what in the bracket what code we want to execute we can do, and after that bracket is closed. For example, the next is the example. Let I equals to 0, we initialize let I with the 0, and we need to run this loop until I is less than 3, and we just need to print whatever I value we have for that I, and we increase the value with plus plus operator. So that's how while loop working. And if we are talking about the for loop, I just keep this slide very simple, because maybe I'm aware that some of are very beginner in JavaScript. That's why I keep this slide very simple. Second topic, second loop we have for loop. So if we are talking about the for loop syntax, we have for, and in the bracket we have beginning, after that condition, and after that step, and any code that we want in this block we can easily do, and after that bracket end. So same example that we taken for the while loop, we will take for that for loop. In the for loop we are just using for let I equals to 0. We need to run this loop until I value is less than 3, and we need to increase also that value, and we need to just console that I into the bracket. So that's how the loops working in JavaScript. Next topic, ternary operators and optional op chaining. So what is the ternary operator? So we are not talking about the if else and switch statement in this session, because I am thinking that you all know what is the if else and switch. I'm just talking about the ternary operator and optional chaining. So first thing, how conditional branching working, like we have if statement. So we have variable called X is allowed, and we just use age, in how old are you, we just use that, and we need to run a condition: age is less than 18, then X is allowed true. If age is less than 18, then X is not allowed. That is very simple logic that we want to build, and we need to assign value inside X is allowed, true or false. So that's how we can do in traditional approach. But the ternary op by using ternary operator, how we can do what is the syntax? The variable let result equals to condition, whatever condition we have. If condition is fulfilled, then we need to use question mark, and it will return the value. And if this condition is false, then we return second value. For our case, we have constant, because it will only the read, currently we have only read only access. So we created a variable called X is allowed using const, and we have a condition: age is greater than 18, then we just need to return true. If age is less than 18, then we need to return false. So if you see that code, it will cover almost 5 to 6 lines, and it only cover single line, and also it is very clean and neat, clean, and we can easily understand. The first is the condition. If condition fulfilled, then what value we need to return, and if condition is false, then what value we need to return. So that's how ternary operator working. The new thing launch, currently just launch, optional chaining. What is the optional chaining? So if we have an object called user, and inside user we are thinking inside user we have a property called address, and address also an object. Inside address we have a street, and previously if we need to check is that these value available or not, if we directly apply and if these value are not coming from server or any object, any third party way, then it will return error because we use undefined property. If suppose that address is not available and we trying to access street, then it will return the error. But using optional chaining, we don't need to apply if condition, like if user is available and user dot right address available and user dot address dot street available. So previously we need to check three things: user is available, user dot address is available, user dot address dot street available, then we can access the this value. But using optional chain, we can directly use that, we can avoid these three check. We just need to use user question mark, it automatically check is user available, then we need to check user dot we need to check address. If address also available by using question mark dot, then we are getting the street. So that's how we can show the very clean code, or we can use very clean code in our JavaScript file. If you have any question on optional chaining, we can please post in the sheet so we can discuss in next session. Next topic, we have functions. So the function is the main building block of a program. That is the some code, some piece of code that may be called many time, or many time, or in different places, that known as a function. We already seen pre-built example like to string, parse int, or these kind of building block, because inside these method there is some logic that check is that integer, is that parse, is that float, is that string. So these kind of, it will contain piece of code that will return a value, or maybe the check a value, is it true or false. So that can be a variable, sorry, a function. If we are talking about how we can define naming, how we can you create, we can put the name for a function, we just need to keep in mind these kind of rules that we have for naming a function. Functions basically are action, so their names should be a verb. For example, on click, yeah, means on row clicks. So this kind of thing, it should be brief, as accurate as possible, describe what the function does. So I already said that on click, so it means it click, whenever user click on that method, it will this method call. Or for example, we have show message, that basically what only do, it only show the messages that we have. So that's how we can name the function. Second, how we can pass a variable parameter. How we can pass a parameter inside a function. So we taken previous function, previous example, we have function called show messages, and previously we are just printing a static text, but right now we are just passing two parameter inside that function. First is the form and second is the text, and by concatenating we just need to showing alert to the user. And whenever we are calling this method, we just need to pass two parameters, the any and hello, and it will return, it will alert the any hello that we are passing. So that's how we can pass the parameter. One more interesting concept we have in JavaScript is called default language. So if suppose that we have two variable, and some code or piece or somewhere we are calling this method, we have only available one variable, another variable we don't have for that right of that time of point. So what we can do, we can assign any default value. For example, in this text, in this example, we have we are just passing single value and it accepting two parameter. But what we can do, we can pass a default value. So from is coming from another method and text is having default value, no text given. And that's how we can use the default value in JavaScript. So whenever we are creating any function, we need to keep in mind, so is we need to give any default value or not, because if we are not given any default value or we call any this method and not given a parameter, it will return error. These two example not returning any value from that. If we want to return any value from a function, how we can do? We just need to use return keyword. So we have function called sum and we are accepting two parameter a and b, and it will return a plus b. What is the value we have? So that is the simple method that we are creating, and whenever we are calling that method, what we can do, we are just doing we are just creating a variable, a let result equals to, and we are calling method with the two parameter. It will return the sum value into the result, and we are just using that result for alert purpose. That's how we can return a value. So that is the vanilla or maybe the traditional approach we are following for creating any function or using any function. Now we have another method or another concept introduced in ESC called arrow function, that also called fat arrow functions. So if we are talking about the arrow function, it is not just shortened of any function. It is basically very meaningful way or meaningful way by declaring this method. So previously we are facing issue with the this keyword, like this is the referring to the current context or current application context or maybe the current page context. So we are facing many time issue with the this context, context. But using arrow function, this error or this problem is resolved now. So what we can do for using arrow function, if we are having if we have only one parameter, then how we can do parameter and that arrow sign that we have an expression. And if we have multiple parameters, then how we can do parameter 1 colon parameter 2 arrow method and expression. And if you are thinking we are not given any name for this method function, so we will explain this example. So with a single parameter, we don't need to use any bracket. We just need to pass the parameter arrow function, and whatever expression we have, we just need to perform. And if we have multiple parameter, then we need to use bracket, parameter 1, parameter 2, and so on. And after that, arrow method, and it will return the expression. So we have a method. We have a method. We have example function time 2. In this, we are just passing the parameter, and it will return 2 time value of that. It will multiply with a 2 and return the value. And that's how we created previously. So we have function parameter into 2, and whenever we are calling this method and passing the value, it will return the output. So that is the traditional approach. But in case of the arrow function, we are creating we are using any variable type, like the variable name, after that parameter param, it's returning what it return parameter into 2. So the complete piece of code is changed in single line. And whenever we need to call, we just need to call times 2 equals to 4. Yeah, time 2 and pass the parameter that we have, and it will return the value. So that's how arrow function is behaving.
Okay, so we have some time, I think 5-10 minutes left before we end the session. So we have some questions already posted by people, so we can take those questions, at least some of them, and so that would be great. So I'll bring up the question. So first question is, why to use let when we have a where keyword available as globally?
So we discuss about the scope. So in case of where keyword, we have a global context. Let's take an example where you declared a variable at the top of the file, a name, and name equals to ABC. And if you want to declare another variable that having same name, you declare a variable called age, and you need to create another variable with the name age. So how you can do? Because you already declare, you just need to reassign the value. So that kind of thing creating many issue in vanilla JavaScript or old JavaScript, because we don't have any kind of block level scoping. So if we need to use this value inside that particular block
Yeah.
and
On the same, there was question like, so the difference between where and let is just because of the scope. Is there
yeah.
anything, any other difference apart from this, or just it, that's the difference between where and let, the
Yeah,
scope?
that is the only difference. But apart from this, they divided this where into the two parts, like read-only part and the changeable part. So read-only part is known as a constant, and the mutable thing is known as a let. But previously we have only the where keyword, and by this we are not differentiate is this value is only readable or read-only or like changeable.
Okay, sounds good. Next question I have is, are the rules for variable creation same for where, let, and const for all of the three, or is it there is a
No,
difference?
these are the same rule for all the three variables. But
Okay.
I'm just suggest you please avoid using where. Try to use let and const. So that is the recommended way from Salesforce as well as the other JavaScript framework.
Okay. And next question is, what's the difference between small s string and the capital S string?
So
Can you give some example?
that is the part of our next section.
Okay,
So
we'll cover that in the next session. Cool. And next is, why do we need let and when we can declare it without any keyword? Example, m equals to 5. Like, if, without writing any let, we can also declare a variable.
yeah, we can declare, but if suppose that you want to write a clean code, then you need to show why this variable is used. Then you need to use the let keyword.
Okay, just a best practice.
Just the best practice.
Okay, and object.create, does it creates a new object type or a record?
It will create a new object type, object data type, not a new record.
Okay, and next is, why to use the new way of conversion instead of implicit? Any difference, like the one we use with the escape character, like the dynamic binding one, why to use that instead of implicit convert? What are the
Just
use
for the
case?
short, just for the short end, like for example, in your LWC component, you have different variables, like let you first name that we already taken, let we have second last name, and let we have third variable called age, and we just need to bind all the three in a single keyword. Then how we can use, because by using explicit, we can just convert one data type to another data type, like a string to number to string. But if you want to concatenate all the three, then how we can use it? That's why we are using that plus or escape character.
Okay, great. I think then we have already the open question for the true equals to true thing. We'll cover that maybe in the next session. And last one is, what is the output to use parse int? And in the parse int, if you are passing any object, so in the parse int, if you put any object, what
It
would
will
be the
return
output?
NaN,
NaN. Okay, so it
not
will
a
return
number.
not a number. Okay. And how to parse something to Boolean? What is, like, we you shared, right? Like the 0, NaN. If you parse them into Boolean, it gives you false. So what is the method or something which we can use to parse them to Boolean? Is there a
Okay, I
method?
just I think for that we just need to use true or false, like just object dot value or that kind of thing.
Okay. Like, is
is
there a
there like
method or
for
something?
example yeah for example we have a variable called let username, and username is equals to abc, correct? And we need to convert in this into the boolean. Then how we can do, we just need to compare with the any other value, then it will return true or false.
Okay, so we can directly straightforward use them in a comparison
Or we
scenario.
can use or we can use capital B and boolean, that boolean, and same as we are using parse int, we just need to use boolean, and inside we can just pass the value.
Okay,
But that
I
is not
think.
recommended way, that capital B.
Wait, I think no. Okay, REST is, I think, include is part of ES6 or ES7. I think we didn't cover this topic. We'll cover maybe next session. So I think that's all questions we have for
What is
today.
the last question? What is the last question we have?
In includes is part of ES6 or ES7.
Okay. We will cover in arrays when we are discussing about the array, because includes only working with the array, or maybe
I think we didn't
procedure.
cover this topic today, so that's why I didn't got this question. Okay, cool. It was great session, Kamal. If you can just go next.
And guys, please share your feedback.
Yeah,
Nishant, you can
there
give your
would be a
feedback.
mail coming to you all to share
We
your
can
feedback, so you
improve.
can share the feedback and we can bring more sessions or how we can do something better in the session. That also, if you can share, will come up in the next sessions. And do register for the next session.
I have one thing, I just want to know, can you just please cover the arrow function a bit in more detail in the next session, because we want to know a bit more about how you can utilize the arrow function, because as you said that we can bypass the traditional function approach and utilize the arrow function. So can you just cover a small topic with example in the next session?
Okay. So we can do one thing. We can whenever from next time, whatever example we are doing with the array, we will cover with the arrow function.
That would be great, because we know a bit of a traditional approach, so this was something new, and it looks a bit, the code was a bit less as compared to the main function traditional approach. So just thought to give a suggestion a bit that if you can cover, then it would be really good for us.
And
Sure.
hey Kamal, it would be good if we can, you know what, by including this arrow function with promise, that would be fine, and
Yeah,
that would be helpful.
that is our day three topic. We will
Day
cover
three.
that. Yeah, we will
Okay,
cover
okay,
the
okay.
promise, then we will cover that particular thing.
Okay, okay,
Yeah,
okay.
we'll cover
So
those
basically, the
topics as
thing
well.
is, we are registering the another sessions as well. Is
Yeah,
there any
can you
way can
Kamal,
you?
go next slide, please, Kamal. Yeah, so these are the links to register for the next two sessions, the day two and day three session. Just register for those session also so that you get your link to join the meetups. Those are
Perfect, perfect.
personal. We don't open the sessions for everyone, like a general link. Just give RSVP and then you get the link there.
Can you post this URL into the chat?
Sure.
A couple of people are joining us from phone as well,
Yeah,
For
you can
sure. I
post in
will
mail
post on the
if
Twitter
it's.
as well. I will post it on the Twitter as well. Just follow the LKSF devs.
You can post in mail also. It would be nice, useful for us.
I'll send the mail to the people who have RSVP'd for today's session for the next session as well. Don't worry.
Okay, thanks. No, thank you.
You would
Thanks.
get these links. No worries.
That is really helpful. Thanks a lot.
Okay, so it was a great session. Thank you.
Thank you very much, everyone, for joining today.
Thank you.
Thank you. Looking forward to the next
Cool.
session. Thank
Yeah.
you.